Spain is a European country with a very colorful history. The Romans, Carthaginians, Visigoths, and the Moors were actors on its historical stage before the Reconquista. Even today, Spain is made up of people with distinct regional identities, cultures, and dialects. Hey everyone, CJ here, with another episode of Open the World Map. This time, I've got a wonderful opportunity to speak with Rodrigo, the translator of the Spanish version of 5th edition Dungeons & Dragons. He works as a professor and also has his own game publishing company that translates other games too, such as the Spanish version of Ryutama and Dungeon Crawler Classic. So in my opinion, he is the best person to speak to understand more about the Spaniards' tabletop role-playing habits. But before we land in Spain, I ask him how would other Dungeons & Dragons fans in the Spanish-speaking world receive the Spanish translation done by Spaniards?
That's a very interesting topic because since we are based in Spain, we translate with the Spanish people in mind. And the Spanish that we speak in Spain is in some aspects very different to the one spoken in America, in Mexico, in Chile, in Argentina, Uruguay, and so on. So what we do is, since the bulk of the sales is going to be here in Spain, we translate to the Spanish from Spain, but we try to avoid some words that we know would have a very different meaning in other versions of Spain. For instance, there's a word which is very usual in Spanish Spain, which is to take something, to grab something, but that same word in Mexican Spanish or American Spanish might mean to make love to somebody. So when we can, we try to avoid that. Usually people in North America or in countries near to the USA prefer the English versions because sometimes they are more used to English in normal use. But other countries, more in the south, they still prefer the Spanish version.
Is Dungeons & Dragons the most popular tabletop role-playing game in Spain?
It's true that Dungeons & Dragons, the Red Box, was the first RPG that was published here, but it wasn't the most popular at the beginning. We played a lot of RuneQuest, Call of Cthulhu, Middle-earth role-playing, the Lord of the Rings one, but nowadays D&D is getting a huge resurgence, a renaissance here, D&D. My publisher, the ones to hire me for the translation, told me that the runs of the books run out pretty quickly and they need to reprint, so they are in fact surprised by it.
I know that many Europeans can speak English, and the English version came out a while ago. Wouldn't Spanish gamers have bought the English version already?
Some people thought that it might not be a success, because it had been already available in English for a long time, so people won't buy it. But the contrary happened. It had a huge success. We see like the same 300 or 500 people active, but there are much more sales of books. So there must be a lot of people there that don't talk about RPGs in the internet, probably they don't know English very much, and they just go to the store and play.
Are there other tabletop RPGs more popular than D&D?
I know that in the English-speaking world, D&D is kind of synonymous with RPG, but here in Spain, traditionally, there were other games. I think the most popular was Call of Cthulhu, and nowadays I think it's a tie between Call of Cthulhu and D&D.
Where do Spaniards play their tabletop RPGs?
I think most people play at home. Teenagers or people that hire flats don't have that space, and they go to public parks or to some youth centers. In some stores, you can play them, but I don't think many people do that. But people who are starting, yes, they go to stores.
Do they play Adventurers League?
We don't have an Adventures League here in Spanish, so the people that do that use the one in English. They read the adventures, translate them themselves. There's another clone of D&D 5th edition here in Spain, done from another company using the SRD, and they have an organized play campaign similar to Adventures League. But the problem with organized play is that usually we don't have enough players that play outside their home with their friends to do that. The only one, in fact, that I know that is successful is this one.
Does Spain have D&D influencers like Critical Role?
I know that there are several actual play YouTube channels or Twitch channels which are pretty popular. In fact, we have a party. In a D&D party organized by the company, and they stream the last session of a Twitch campaign by a group called Rolazo. We have our influencers, so to speak, but they are not at the level of the ones that you have in the United States.
How do Spaniards play tabletop RPGs differently?
I think we put, incidentally or not, a lot of humor in our home-produced games. The first, the most popular in the English-speaking world is probably Anima, because this one has been translated into English. I think it was the first one. There's another one called The End of the World, which is published in English by Fantasy Flight Games, and that's also by a Spanish author.
Can you tell us what other games Spaniards have created?
The thing is, the first RPG made in Spain was Aquelarre, in the late 80s, and it's based on a medieval version of Spain, which is different from the more usual northern one, in which we have this interplay of Muslims, Jews, and Spanish. We have all the trappings that you could imagine, like the Spanish Inquisition and the witch hunt, and so on. And it has a lot of dark humor into it. And that's been translated into English by, I think, Nocturnal Media. It was financed by a Kickstarter, if I recall correctly. There are many games, but if I want to feature those that use some Spanish-only motifs, sorry for the plug, but my company has published one called Hablaneda. That is a very, very humoristic game. It's its point, in fact. It's very rules-light, and it's based in the all the horrible things that happens to a road guard that finds all the monsters of the Spanish medieval mythology and all the miseries of the rural Spain. We tend to have games more focused in particular aspects of our history, with probably the exception of the Civil War, because probably it's a hot topic still.
What pop culture media influences Spaniards' roleplay?
Comic influence from France, because they have a fantastic comic industry, and we get a lot of work from there, which is a country that is very near Spain. And in fact, many Spanish illustrators and some writers go to France to create comics. And I like anime and the Japanese world a lot. And I thought that maybe that was something that some people like and some people didn't. But the summary is that Japanese media got to Italy, and from Italy it got to Spain sooner than in other parts of the world, because Spanish and Italian are very similar. So in the 70s, we had Japanese animation in the television, the public television. We didn't know it was from Japan or not necessarily, but it arrived here earlier. So that's why I think we are more influenced by Japanese media than other countries.
Can you recommend some fantasy or sci-fi work from Spain?
It's difficult, because in Spain we don't have a tradition for the fantastic or the science fiction. Probably because we have been under a regime until very recently, with the Franco regime, in which fantasy was not seen as a good or desirable things. We tend to, especially older generations, tend to like more the real things.
Can you tell us more about your company? What do you guys do?
I started this company when I wrote my first game, which is called La Puerta de Istar, the Istar's Gate, which is Mesopotamian fantasy. I like that area of the world very much, and I wanted a fantasy game based on the Mesopotamian, Assyrian, Sumerian, Akkadian myths, so I created it, and we are trying to translate it to English. In the meantime, we will continue to offer some rural fantasy supplements for Dungeon Crawl Classics. And in Spanish, we are about to release a game called Masks of the Empire, Máscaras del Imperio in Spanish, in which the players are these pulp heroes like Zorro or Batman or the Adam Savage, but in the 7th century. We also have a partnership with Andy Kitkowski, which you interview, so we co-publish with him the games that he translates to English from Japanese. We have published Ryutama, and we want to publish Tenra Bansho Zero. For D&D, we have produced, Asmodee has released the three core books, the starter set, and we began with the Tome of Annihilation, which I received just the last week, and we are very happy with the results that we are getting.
All right, here comes everybody's favorite question. What is your secret sauce for dungeon mastering?
I think not being ashamed by doing funny voices and speak strange things. My players love my NPCs. Sometimes they spend a whole session talking with them, even if they have no special a role in the adventure, because they like this particular bartender or this bystander.
Finally, I ask him if there is any message he would like to deliver to other Spaniards.
Even if it's difficult, we should make an effort to translate our games into English or offer them to English publishers. Because other countries have been very good at that. Sweden, like this Mutant Year Zero or Tales from the Loop, Japan, of course, and I think we could do the same.
And that was Rodrigo, the Spanish translator of the 5th edition Dungeons & Dragons. You can find the link to his Twitter and website in the description section below. Before I end the video, let me give thanks to my Patreon supporters for supporting this series. If you like what I'm doing, consider joining Patreon so that you can also ask questions to our future interviewee. Subscribe to the channel and remember to click on future videos so that you can open the world map as we explore tabletop RPG cultures from all around the world. CJ, over and out.